topic in our automobile engineering, that is steering system. Okay, so first of all we have seen that the what is steering system. Okay, so steering system is nothing but a way of steering to move in way what we have to तुम्हाला ज्या दिशेने जायचं असेल, राईट, किंवा तुम्हाला ज्या दिशेला जायचं असेल त्याप्रकारे तुम्ही स्टेअरिंग व्हील तुमचं जे आहे ते यूज करून तुम्ही जाऊ शकता, राईट. सो अ सिंपल मेकॅनिझम फॉर व्हेकल टू मूवमेंट ऑफ व्हेकल विथ द लॉंग ऑफ वे ऑर द वॉट काइंड ऑफ वे यू हॅव टू गो. सो सिंपल यू हॅव टू फर्स्टली स्टार्ट बेसिक स्टेअरिंग सिस्टीम. ओके, so you have to see the picture of steering system. Simple, a steering column, then steering shaft, right, then a simple tire rod joints, then tire rod, right, then rack and pinion. So these are the simple basic steering systems, right. So in this steering system there are different types of components are using in steering system. So these are the components: steering columns, steering shafts, tire rod, tire rod joints, rack and pinion. Okay, then first one by one we have getting these parts. So first is pinion gear. Okay, rotated by the steering wheels and steering shaft, its teeth mesh with the teeth of rack. Okay, so first of all we have to see that the diagram, right. So in this diagram we have to see that a steering column, right. So steering column and the steering tire rod shaft, right. So this steering shaft and tire rod are connected with the help of teeth, right. So in this in this teeth, right, so the steering shaft teeth and the tire rod teeth are connected with each other with the help of this pinion gear, right. So next is rack. Long steel shaft with the teeth along the one section slides side away as the pinion gear turns, right. This tire rod, right, this tire rod is a simple rack or a gear teeth, right. That gear teeth is known as simple part is known as rack, right. And this upward shaft connected with that rack with the help of pinion, right. So the next is tire rod. Okay, connects the rack with the steering knuckle, right. With the help of this tire rod the rack with the steering knuckles are connects. Okay, then next, the working principle of steering mechanism. When the steering is steered, the power is transferred to the front steering gearbox and the bevel gear arranged is made to the transfer the power to the rear steering wheel, right. You have to see that when we have to je tumcha steering column ahe, right, tumhi ja dishene firavta tya dishene te firta, right, ta tya steering column la, right, tumcha jo tire rod ahe, right, tya thikane tumcha ek steering gear mechanism pan ahe kiwa steering gear box pan ahe, right, they are fitted. Okay, bevel gear is used to transmit the rotary motion perpendicularly, so the one bevel gear is introduced in the front steering rod. The other bevel gear is connected to the transfer rod, right. Je steering gear box ahe tumcha, right, tyachyamadhe tumcha bevel gear ha use kela jata. Okay, you have to see in a third year there is a unit of bevel gear, right. So that bevel gear are used in your steering gear box, right. So two supports are used to support the transfer rod. Transfer rod is connected to the rear steering rear steering gearbox. Rear steering gearbox is fixed to the car body by bolts and nuts, and the ends of the steering box are connected to the rear wheel hub where our tires are mounted, right. So this transfer rod, two supports are connected with the help of the steering gearbox, and this steering gearbox are fixed to the car body or bolted with the car body, and this steering box, right, is connected to your rear hub, rear wheel hub, right, and the rear wheel hub are connected to your the rear wheel hub are mounted a tires, right. As the steering is steered, the rear wheel also turns by the arrangement made and the rear wheel turns in the opposite direction, right? So the next topic is function of steering system, right? There are different types of functions of steering system. So first, one by one we have got to control of the front wheel direction, right? Je tumcha front wheel ahe tyacha control karnyacha kaam हे तुमच्या स्टेरिंग सिस्टीमचं आहे. ओके, ट्रान्समिट रोड फील, राईट, ट्रान्समिट रोड फील टू द ड्रायव्हर्स हँड. मीन्स जे तुमचं कॉलम व्हील, सॉरी व्हील आहे, राईट, स्टेरिंग व्हील आहे, राईट, तर जसं तुम्ही ते व्हील स्टेरिंग व्हील फिरवणार, राईट, तसं तुमचं व्हेकल हे रन होणार, राईट. जर पुढे समोर काही खड्डे वगैरे असतील, राईट, किंवा बाउन्स वगैरे असतील, तर ते बायपास करायचं काम हे कोणाचं असतं, त्या स्टेअरिंग मेकॅनिझमचं, राईट. तर जे ड्रायव्हरच्या हँडमध्ये आहे, राईट, सो ट्रान्समिट रोड फील टू द ड्रायव्हर्स हँड. ओके, मेंटेन करेक्ट अमाऊंट ऑफ एफर्ट निडेड टू टर्न द व्हील्स, राईट. इन दिस स्टेअरिंग सिस्टीम टू मेंटेन करेक्ट अमाऊंट ऑफ इफेक्ट निडेड टू द टर्न द व्हील, राईट. म्हणजे जे तुमच्या व्हील, जसं तुमचा व्हील आहे त्याला जसा टर्न पाहिजे, राईट, तर त्या जेवढा तुम्हाला टर्न आवश्यक आहे तेवढंच टर्न हे तुम्हाला तुमचं स्टेअरिंग सिस्टीम हे देणार आहे. ओके, ॲब्झॉर्ब मोस्ट ऑफ द शॉक्स गोईंग टू द स्टेअरिंग व्हील ॲज द टायर हिट्स होल अँड बम्प्स इन द रोड, राईट. तर स्टेअरिंग जे तुमचं कॉलम आहे किंवा स्टेअरिंग मेकॅनिझम आहे, राईट, जे तुमचं स्टेअरिंग व्हील आहे, राईट, मॅक्झिममली तुमचे जे रोड शॉक्स वगैरे आहेत, राईट, किंवा बम्प्स आहेत ते ॲब्झॉर्ब करतं. ओके, देन अलाव फॉर सस्पेन्शन ॲक्शन, राईट, मीन्स जे तुमचं स्टेअरिंग व्हील आहे, राईट, त्याच्यानुसार तुमचं व्हेकल हे रन होणार आहे, त्याप्रकारे तुमचं व्हेकल हे रन होतं, तर त्याच्यामुळे काय, जी तुमची सस्पेन्शन सिस्टीम आहे ती पण ॲक्शन मोडमध्ये येते, राईट. सो दीज आर द सिम्पल फंक्शन्स ऑफ स्टेअरिंग सिस्टीम. ओके, देन रिक्वायरमेंट्स. ओके, इन स्टेअरिंग सिस्टीम रिक्वायरमेंट मल्टीप्लाय द टर्निंग एफर्ट applied on steering wheel by the driver. It should be to a certain degree irreversible or the mechanism should have self-righting effect. These are the requirements of steering mechanism, right? Then simple construction of steering mechanism. You have to see that in this diagram, you have to see that simple the front section, one minute, okay. These are the simple front section of your vehicle and these are the rear side of your vehicle, right? So the vehicle are steady in mode, right? So the simple when you have studied, okay, so we have to see that the simple turn or the simple wheel to wheel distance, right, of your steering mechanism, right? So in this we have to see that when the vehicle in a steady mode, right, so when the study of steering mechanism, we have to see that the vehicle in steady mode and also the vehicle in on a turning mode, right. So in this we have to see that when the vehicle is on a turning mode, so we have to see that the mechanism is run on vehicles and also a steady time, right. So we have to see that. Okay, so simple the types of steering mechanism, right. So in this types of steering mechanism, there are the two types of steering mechanism. One is a Ackerman steering mechanism and second is Davis steering mechanism, right. So out of this Ackerman steering mechanism is mostly used because is of its simplicity, right. So one first we have taken as Ackerman principle. We have to see that in this diagram, right, the intention of Ackerman geometry is to avoid the need for types of slip sideways when the following the path around the curve. Okay, then the Ackerman steering system, the basic aim of steering is to ensure that the wheels are pointing in the desired direction, right, means simple the vehicle, right, the best aim or basic aim of this steering mechanism is the wheels are pointing in the desired direction, right? This is typically achieved by series of linkages, rods, pivots and gears. One of the fundamental concepts is that of caster angle. Each wheel is steered with a pivot point ahead of the wheels, right? The basic funda of that Ackermann steering mechanism is that the caster angle, right, will be adjusted with the help of pivoted point. Okay, this makes the steering tends to be self-centering towards the direction travel. Okay, Ackermann steering geometry. Okay, so the steering linkages connecting the steering box and the wheels usually conforms to a variation of Ackermann steering geometry to account for the fact that it turns. The inner wheel is actually traveling a path of smaller radius than outer wheels, so that the degree of toe suitable for driving in a straight path is not suitable for turn, right? Simply, when we have turned the vehicle, that time the outer wheel travels more than the inner wheel, right? So that that time the degree of turning of that vehicle, the angle between, right, is more, right? So the path will be is not suitable to turn. Okay, so simple, that is a simple steering mechanism of your steering system. In next lecture we have studied that the steering geometry. Okay.